Hello students, today we have to start with vector set 2.6. From this vector set we have to discuss your question number 5. So what is question number 5? Vivek is the 5 years older than the Kishore. Okay, Vivek is 5 years older than the Kishore. The sum of the multiplicative inverse of their ages is 1/6. Find the present age. Okay, the concept of multiplicative inverse. What is the multiplicative inverse? Suppose I am to calculate multiplicative inverse of x. Then I am to write here 1/x. That means we have to calculate or we have to find out the multiplicative inverse by multiplying this x by what? 1/x². Or directly you have to write down multiplicative inverse of x is 1/x. That means you have to take the inverse. Or if I am write x^-1, when this x^-1 is positive, then I am write 1/x. Okay, so multiplicative inverse of x is 1/x. Similarly, suppose I am to calculate the multiplicative inverse of z, then it is 1/z. Otherwise, 45, multiplicative inverse of 45 is 1/45, or 1 to 4. So what is the multiplicative inverse here? 1/1 to 4. Okay, that means we have to take the inverse of it, reciprocal inverse. Okay, so the sum of the multiplicative inverse of their ages is 1/6, and then we have to find out the present age. Okay, listen. Vivek, there are two persons here, Vivek and Kishore. What is the age of Vivek? Vivek is the 5 years older than Kishore. Suppose I am to let Kishore's present age is equal to x years. Okay. Kishore's present age is x years. Okay. So, what is the first condition? Vivek is the 5 years older than Kishore. That means Vivek is the 5 years what? Older. Okay. Than Kishore. That means we have to add, if the Kishore is 12 years old, then what is the Vivek age? That is 5 years older. Means 12 + 5. That means Vivek age is 17 years. That means we have to add this one. Okay. So, therefore, Vivek present age is equal to x + 5 years. Clear? From the given position. Okay? Suppose I am to write here, from given condition. Clear? Now next. Then we have to done up to this one. Okay? Up to this one. Now next one is what? The sum of the multiplicative inverse of their ages is 1/6. So what is the multiplicative inverse of Kishore present age? You have to write down here. Multiplicative inverse of Kishore's present age is equal to 1/x. Similarly, multiplicative inverse of Vivek present age is 1/x + 5. So what is the given condition here? have to write here. What is given condition? The sum of the contributive inverse of their ages is 1 upon 6. That means we have to add these two. That is from given condition. What we have read? 1 upon x plus 1 upon x plus 5 is equal to 1 upon 6. Okay? 1 upon 6. 1 upon x plus 1 upon x plus 5 is equal to 1 upon 6. So now solve this equation. Just cross multiply here. 1 into x plus 5 plus 1 into x upon x, x plus 5 is equal to 1 upon 6. Now, x plus 5 plus x upon x, x plus 5 is equal to 1 upon 6. Now, x plus x, that is 2x plus 5 upon, yes, 2x 5 upon x square plus 5x is equal to 1 upon 6. Now, just cross multiply. 6 is multiplied by this one and 1 is here. That means 6, 2x plus 5 is equal to x square plus 5x. Okay? So 6 is multiplied bracket here. 6 is multiplied bracket. That is square x plus 30 is equal to x square plus 5x. Yeah? Now next. Just simplify the situation and write x square plus 5x here and change this side of this minus 12x minus 30 is equal to 0. Then x square minus, this one is what? 7x minus 30 is equal to 0. That means we have to get here the equation, that is x square minus 7x minus 30 is equal to 0. So just factorize this equation. Okay. How to factorize this one? We have to get two numbers, like when we multiply these two numbers, we have to get the 30, and when we add, we have to get minus 7. So which are the numbers? That is 10 and 3. Okay. When we have to multiply 10 into 3, what we have to get? Multiplication is minus 30 and addition is minus 7. So when we have, I have to multiply minus 3 into 3, we have to get the minus 30. And when we have to get subtract minus 10 from 3, then what is the answer? That is minus 7. Okay? So these are the two numbers. So just factorize this one. X square minus 10 minus 3. Okay? X minus 30 is equal to 0. Now, x square minus 10x minus minus plus 3x minus 30. 30 or you have to write down 3 into 10 is equal to 0. Clear? Now, I'll write here. That is what we have to take common here, that is x. So put x in bracket. What is remaining? X minus 10. Wait. And erase this part. If you have to write this, note down this part and erase it. Okay. Or take the screenshot of it. Okay. So I have to erase this one. What is next? That is, this one is the given step here. Last step, x square minus 10x plus 3x minus 3 into 10 is equal to 0. So put common x. So x minus 10, put common from this one, that is minus 3. Yes? Minus 3. Or sorry, what we have to take plus 3 common, then x plus, sorry, minus 10 is equal to 0. Now, x minus 10 in one bracket and x plus 3 in another bracket. So, just solve this, x minus 10 is equal to 0 or x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now, what is the value of x? That is 10 or x is equal to minus 3. Okay, x is equal to minus 3. But what is the x here? We have to consider in first step that x is the present age of Kishore. So, x represents age. So, age contains negative value? No. Okay. So, therefore, we have to write here but age what? Cannot be negative. Therefore, x is equal to 10 only. Okay. So, what is the x? That is, x is the what? Kishore's present age. Okay. Therefore, Kishore present age is equal to x is equal to 10 years. Then Vivek present age is equal to x plus 5, which is equal to 10 plus 5, that means 15 years. Okay? Okay, this is the final answer. That is, Kishore's present age is 10 years. Kishore's present is 10 years and Vivek present age is 15 years. Okay? This is the answer of your question number 3. So, if you want to write this, take the screenshot of it. Now, we have to solve the question number 5. Actually, this is the answer of your question number 4, not 3. Yeah? Now, we have to solve the next question. Next question, question number 5. Okay. Suresh scored 10 marks more in the second unit test than the first unit test. Okay. 5 times the marks in the second unit test is equal to the square of the marks in the first unit test. 5 is scored in the first unit test. That means there are two conditions or two substitutions given, that is first unit test marks and second unit test marks. First unit test and second unit test. Okay. So, we have to make first quadratic equation from this one. So, first of all, what is the first condition? Suresh scored 10 marks more than the second unit test than the in the first unit test. That means you have to consider your first unit test marks as x. Okay. Let Suresh score x marks in first unit test. Okay. Therefore, we can say that what is the first condition? The 10 marks more in the second unit test. Therefore, Suresh score 10 more. That means x plus 10 marks in second unit test. Clear? Clear this one? If you have to consider the first unit more, first unit test marks as x, then second unit test marks 10 marks more. That means you have to add x plus 10. So we have to get here two values. Now next one is there, that is 5 times the marks in the second unit test. What is the second unit test marks? That is x plus 10. 5 times means what? We have to multiply 5 throughout this one. So therefore we can write it as 5 times marks in second unit test is equal to what? 5x plus 10. Clear? 5x plus 10. So 5 times the marks in the second unit test is equal to the what? Square of the marks in the first unit test. So what is the first unit test marks? X is x. What is the square of this one? That is x square. So what we have to write? Square of next condition. Square of first unit test marks. What is x square? And these two are the equal entity. Okay, from this one. 5 times the marks in the second unit test is equal to the square of the marks in the first unit test. So what will I write? From given condition, what will I write? That is 5x plus 10 is equal to x square. Okay. Now multiply this 5. 5x plus 50 is equal to x square. Okay, 5x plus 50 is equal to x square. Now, next step, that is 5x, or this full value goes here. Then what happens? X square minus 5x minus 50 is equal to 0. So this is the quadratic equation. Okay, this is the quadratic equation. So factorize this one. What we have to get here? That is multiplication as 50 and addition as minus 5. Clear? So when we have to multiply, what we have to get? Minus 50 and multiplication, and minus 5 as the addition. So minus 50. If I have to multiply 5 into 10, okay, 5 into 10 or 5 into minus 10, what we have to get? Minus 50. And when we subtract 5 or 10 from 5, what we have to get? Minus 5. Clear? So that means there are two numbers, 5 and 10. So write down this one, x square minus 10 minus 5x minus 50 is equal to 0. Now, x square minus 10x plus 5x minus this 50 is written as 5 into 10, which is equal to 0. Now, take common from this one. So, x minus 10 plus 5, x minus 10, 0. Then x minus 10 in one bracket and x plus 5 is in another bracket. Then x minus 10 is equal to 0, or x plus 5 is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 10, or x is equal to minus 5. That means we have to get here x values of what? 10 and minus 5. But marks, is there the marks are negative? No. So what we write? But marks cannot be negative. So what we have to consider here? X is equal to 10 only. What? X is equal to 10. So what we have to find out? Find the his score in the first unit test. So we have to get the first unit test score. Okay, so we have scored x marks in the first unit test, and we have to get the x is equal to 10. So what we have to write? Therefore, Suyash scored 10 marks in first unit test. Clear? So if you want to write this, take a screenshot of it. This is the answer of your question number 5. Okay? 10 marks. Clear? Now next we have to solve the question number 6. Next question. Sixth number question is there. Mr. Kasam runs a small business of making earthen pots. Okay. The one person which does a business which is related to earthen pots, making earthen pots. Okay. He makes certain number of pots on daily basis. Okay. This person makes the pots on the daily basis. Yeah. So, production cost of each pot is 40 rupees more than 10 times the total number of pots he makes in one day. Okay. If the production cost of all pots per day is 600 rupees, find the production cost of one pot and number of pots he makes per day. Okay. So, how to solve this one? So, first of all, consider here x as the earthen pot per day. Okay, what we have to consider? Let Kasam makes x earthen pot per day. Okay, per day. Okay, for each day Mr. Kasam makes the x pots. Okay, earthen pots. Then the cost of each earthen pot is, what is condition here? Cost of each earthen pot is 40 more than the 10 times of total number of pots. Suppose I have to consider the x as the total number of pots per day. Okay. Then 10 times means what? We have to multiply this 10 and it is the 40 more than. Means we have to add 40 now. Then how to write? The cost of each earthen pot is the cost of each earthen pot is what? 10 times total number of pots. What is total number of pots per day? That is x. So 10 times is what? 10x. And it is a 40 rupees 40 more than it. Means we have to add the 40 more than. Clear? Okay, cost of each earthen pot per day. Okay, this is for what? Per day. Per day. Okay, these are the two basic concepts. Now next one is there, that is the production cost of all pots per day is 600 rupees. Means we have to multiply this one. From given condition, what is the production cost total? That is 600. That means x number of pots makes in per day. And the cost of this x number of pots is what? 10x plus 40. So, total number of the cost of production cost is 600. So, what we have to do here? We have to multiply this one. X 10x plus 40 is equal to 600. This is the 600 given. Yeah? So, solve this equation. That is 10x squared plus 40x is equal to 600. Now 10x square plus 40x minus 600 is equal to 0. So just divide this 10 throughout this one. Then what we have to get? That is x square. What we have to get? X square plus 4x minus 60 is equal to 0. Why? Because we have to divide throughout this bracket. What? Dividing 10. Here? Dividing 10. Now next, solve this equation. That is, we have to get here. What is the equation? X square plus 4x minus 60 is equal to 0. So we have to get multiplication as 60 minus 60 and addition as 4. So when we multiply 10 into 6, okay, 10 into 6, we have to get 60. So minus and put here. So minus 60. So when we subtract 6 from 10 or 10 from 6, then what is the answer? That is what? Sorry, 6 here. Answer is 4. That means there are two numbers, that is 10 and 6. Okay? 10 and 6. So write here x square plus 10 minus 6 x minus 60 is equal to 0. Then x square plus 10x minus 6x minus 60 is equal to 0. Put common here. Or take common x is out of the bracket. Then x plus 10 minus 6 x plus 10 is equal to 0. Then x plus 10 in one bracket, x minus 6 in another bracket. Now next, x plus 10 is equal to 0 or x minus 6 is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 10, sorry, minus 10 or x is equal to 6. That means you have to get here x is equal to 10, minus 10 and x is equal to 6. But the cost is, okay, what is the x? We have to consider x as the earthen pot. Okay, we have mixed earthen pot. But can earthen pot is negative? No, it is not negative. So therefore, we skip this value, that is x is equal to minus 10. Therefore, we have to put here x is equal to 6 only. So how to write the number of earthen pot cannot be negative here. Okay, but number of earthen pots cannot be negative. Therefore, x is equal to 6. That means number of earthen pots are what? Number of earthen pots are 6 here. Okay, what we have to take? 6 and the number of earthen pots. We have to find out the production of cost of one pot and number of earthen pots makes per day. Number of earthen pots makes what? X is the answer of this one. Now we have to calculate the cost of the each earthen pot. So which formula we have to put here? That is 10x minus 40. Okay. So how to write? The cost of each earthen pot is equal to the cost of each earthen pot is equal to 10x plus 40. That means 10 into 6 plus 40. It is 16 plus 40. That means it is 56. What? 56 Sorry, this one is 50, not 56. We have to multiply. 60 plus 40, it is 100. Sorry. Because multiplication sign is there, it is 100. Okay? So therefore, what you have to write? This one is in a rupees. Therefore, he makes 6 earthen pots in what? Earthen pots per day and cost of it is rupees 100. Okay, clear? This is the answer. This one is the first answer and this one is the second. So I hope you have to understand this example here. This is the example number 6 from practice 2.6. So I hope you have to understand from this video. So please like it, subscribe it, and share with your friends. Thank you, students.